You'll be highest and you'll be in the heavenly consciousness and at the same time, earthly. You'll allow yourself to be in the multifarious activities, but your highest height you do not lose. You are doing something very serious. Very serious you are doing. At the same time, if somebody comes and tells you, gives you a message, somebody is coming and telling earthly thing, you are in your highest absolute. So this one called Sahaja Samadhi, that spontaneous Samadhi. For the other one, I have to meditate like this, I have to go like this, going. So first one is Sabhikalpa, I am here, then Nirvikalpa goes there. Then Nirvikalpa Samadhi, that one, that you know, Lord Buddha and others prescribe, that one. And Sahaja is there, you go to the highest, and again, you can work in the lowest means on earthly, mundane activities, but you are not losing your highest consciousness. You don't lose. You remain in your highest, at the same time, earthly, mundane activities you are doing. People are talking to you, you are talking to them, but you are not at all affected. Like the boat. The boat is, you see, under the water a little, and again on top. But the one that is under the water is not affected, because that is what you take the connection. A portion of the boat is under the water, portion is above the water. So now what happens? The same boat is going from here to the destination, going on. Both are needed. Under the water you are needed, again over the water, above the surface level. So they go together, side by side. And the boat under, and again on top of the surface, they are going together. So that one is like Sahaja Samadhi, but that is very difficult. Yeah. That is the most difficult. The other two, of course, all are by degrees. When we study in primary school, it is easy compared. Then high school, then you go to college and university, it becomes more and more difficult. But then, when you go to the highest, you get master's degree and PhD and all that, we do not forget the letter alphabet, A, B, C, D. No, because of this alphabet, A, B, C, we are able to go to in the highest. Because you learn the alphabet, we went high. Because we had the seed, we are able to become the plant and the tree. So in life always, there is this ocean, vast ocean. There are countless drops. Now the ocean, as soon as you separate ourselves, we enjoy the game of separativity. I am a tiny drop, and separate. And then my existence, if somebody takes a drop and puts it on the ground, in a few minutes, I am completely gone. I mean, but the same drop, when it enters the ocean, I become invisible, inseparable with the mighty ocean. Here, when I enjoy my separativity, I am put outside, in a few minutes, I am gone totally. It is all. But when I enter into the ocean, I become the mighty ocean. Nobody can say, oh, where is the tiny drop? The tiny drop has become part and parcel of the ocean, and it has become the ocean itself. So now you can separate the existence of the little tiny drop. So this way, again, this drop, one, two, three, countless drops have made the ocean. So one becomes many, again many become one. So source is one. The seed, only one seed. Then when it germinates, when it became, how many branches? How many flowers? How many leaves? Countless fruits. Everything is countless. But the origin is one. One seed. So we can't separate. If you take up the roots, when first you see, then the tree won't last. All is the foundation, to speak. It mentioned, if you take the foundation away, there's nothing, it will all collapse. So we again pay attention to the root, to the foundation. But then we have to claim each other. The foundation, the top buildings, there are so many stories, they have to claim the foundation. As they say, if there's no foundation, then building will collapse. Again, this foundation is so proud, like mother and the child, mother and children. Mother is so proud of her children. Mother perhaps didn't go to school. Mother is illiterate. And the son is now a great literary figure, great scholar. But the son comes and touches the feet of the mother. And the mother is so proud that her son. So we have to claim always. The root has to claim, and also the topmost branch also has to claim their root together, like the mother and the son. So Hinduism is like that. Hinduism is all the time flowing. Hinduism is not static. Hinduism is a running river, murmuring. It is going to the infinite ocean. Hinduism is not like the static, the stagnant pool. No, Hinduism is a river flowing all the time. Day and night, ceaselessly towards the ocean. The ocean of, we use the term consciousness. The ocean of consciousness, it is entering to the ocean of consciousness. So this is our way of accepting Hinduism and offering to the world at large the meaning of Hinduism. Now again, there are two types of Hinduism. One type, they say, I am a Hindu. I have nothing to do with Muslim or Islam or Christian. No. We say no. I am a Hindu, but I have a big heart, very big heart. I claim you to be my brother, to be inside my heart. Then it is real Hinduism. When mother sees that her children have many, many friends all over the world, mother doesn't stop her children. No, you have to remain my own. Nothing. I won't allow you to mix with so and so, even with the neighbors. No. The stupid mother will not allow. But the mother has a heart. My son, he is universal. He has friends in England, France, Germany, Austria, and everywhere in Australia. My mother takes pride in her son's achievement. She is village lady, illiterate. But her son is so great, good, so good. All over the world, he has established friendship. And so now see, the mother is so proud for her son's acceptance of the whole world as his own, very own, faster than the person. So the mother gets tremendous joy and pride in her son's achievement all over the world. Similarly, when real Hinduism comes, this is called Sanatana Dharma, universal, the birthless and deathless. This dharma is eternal. He says, when you use the term eternal, it becomes birthless and deathless. It has no birth, it has no death, like this. So when we say Hinduism, it accepts the whole world, they are all inside. Real, divine Hinduism. Again, human one, qualified by the mind. This is the boundary. I will call it Hinduism. You call it Islam, or Christianity, or Judaism, any. There we are miserable. Only when we sit together, eat together, we are happy. If I am alone to eat a mango, I may get little joy. But if I invite my friends, my brothers, my sisters, my friends, my acquaintances, and share with them the mangoes that I am eating, I get tremendous joy. By accepting, by inviting, by embracing them as my own, I get much more joy. So here Hinduism, in its pristine form, is acceptance. Main Hinduism will always tolerate. Tolerance is the main thing. If others are doing something, we have to tolerate them. They are ignorant. When a child does something wrong, is a mischievous boy, does it, mother tolerates. Father tolerates it. Then the child grows up, then he knows how to behave.